I'm Michael, and this is Toucan Play That Game. And today we are finishing our look at Kemet. So today will be our review. If you still need to learn how to play the game or want to see an example of the game being played, please check out my previous videos, for which there are links in the description. So, what do I think about Kemet? Well, first, let's talk about the artwork. I like to start there when I'm doing my reviews, as it's the first impact the game actually has on you. And the artwork in this is very nice. Now, it can be a bit drab feeling, a bit browny almost, but I think that is done on purpose. It's that kind of deserty, sandy kind of feel it's trying to get across. And the board, everything works very nice. The artwork on the board has the same feel as the artwork on the cars. It all works nicely together. The design of the board is all very clear. You can easily tell the different segments. You've got colour coding on the lines for the temples and for the Sanctuary of All Gods to show that that's different. So it is very nice. The components. Now, this is where Kemet probably shines the most. Look at the creatures. I mean, just look at them for a second. They are wonderful models. They are absolutely fantastic minis. I think they've done a great job with this. They look amazing and they just make you go, wow, these are nice. I really want to get those creatures just because I want to be able to sit there and look at it. And it doesn't stop there. The component quality on the board is good. The component quality on the tokens is good. The component quality on the pyramids. Well, I call them pyramids. They are simply D4s. But they might just be D4s, but they're really nice D4s. You hold those in your hand, they have a nice weight, they have a nice feel to them. They look nice with that kind of marbly effect. It's really nice on the components. I can't say anything bad about the components. Well, I say I can't say anything bad. There's one small thing, and that is the quality of the plastic on the little units. Now, I know this is done to keep costs down. It is this kind of cheap, well, it's not cheap, but it's that soft, pliable plastic. So they can get a bit mangled over time, and they're not as detailed as some minis would be. But if you're going to have that many in a place, you need them to be relatively small, and they definitely do the job, and they are all different looking as well as different colours for the different gods. So I do like them. It's just a shame that they're not nicer, but I couldn't really say how you could make them nicer, so they've done the best of what they could. Now, let's get down to what really matters, and that is, of course, the gameplay. Now, Kemet is one of my favourite games. It has a beautiful mix of strategy with just this little hint of luck. And of course, that hint of luck only comes from those divine intervention cards. But just by adding those cards to the game, just introduces that one small element where you never know what's going to happen when you have a battle or at any point in the game. You know, each round you're getting luck. And it's not a huge amount of luck. It probably isn't enough to mitigate a bad strategy, for example. But it can occasionally just tilt that balance in your favour. Like, you manage to recruit just a couple of units when you need them. You manage to ignore walls just when you need them. You manage to do that extra bit of damage that they didn't think you could do in a battle. It works fantastically. And of course, because you have that deterministic form of battle with the selecting of the cards, and again, it's a fantastic mechanic. It works lovely. With the whole picking one to use, picking one to discard, your brain is burning the whole time. Every decision you're making feels important. It feels like the game will hinge on this decision. But not in a bad way. It feels really fun. It doesn't feel as heavy as that would maybe make it seem. You can choose to make this as heavy as you want to make it, basically. If you want to sit there and go, then you can. If you want to go, I attack, throw everything at them, and I want to hit them with as much damage as I can, then you can do that, and it can be light and fun as well. And it is a beautiful game for that. And then let's talk about what is my favourite thing mechanically about Kemet, and that is the power tiles. Now, obviously the connection of you have to raise your pyramids, and therefore you're kind of setting yourself down a path of going for this colour or that colour, but then the way you combine them and the way you choose to buy different power tiles and combine them, and seeing what other people are buying and going, oh, I need to counteract that. So if I buy this combination, it'll counteract that. It works really well because there's no hidden aspect to it of, they've got that card somewhere, but I don't know if it's going to come up. I can buy this card and hope that it comes up at the right time to counteract it. No, you know exactly what they've got. You know exactly how they can potentially use it, except for those divine intervention cards, which are only a small aspect. So you can see what other people are planning and plan against it, almost in a chess-like way. But at the same time, if you don't want to do that, this is a game you can play and be destroyed at. And trust me, I have done this and still have a fantastic time. I had one game where basically I had spent ages and ages building up, and I was gonna get my own back. I was building up this destroyer army that would be a case of, I would go in, I would wipe out the opposition, whether or not I won or not, I would wipe them out, get a load of prayer points, but then allow me to build up quicker, replace my units, etc, etc. And then the game finished. And so in that final turn, I was like, well, I could try and prolong the game slightly, but I'm finally in the position where I can do this killing and get my prayer points, so I want to kill people! And I did the killing. Because it was what was fun, and it felt appropriate. As I say, this is one of my favourite games. I've gone through a bit about some of my favourite mechanics, but the key thing is, the way those mechanics combine and mesh together is what makes the game really work and really fun. And one thing that is important with this is they did that variable board. Now, obviously, you've got the two sides, which is smart thinking, works fantastically. But then they thought to go, we've got left and right bank here. Let's use those as well. And it just is fantastic. It means no matter how many players you have an appropriately sized board that works for that game. You have, I'm not saying the exact same gameplay, but it scales so well for all the different players. And I have played all the different players on this. And I wouldn't say there's a favourite number. I would say that as you go up in numbers, there's maybe more you need to remember of what this person's doing, this person's doing, this person's doing, etc. And there's a lot more competition on what power tiles you want to get that make it feel like a different game. And in many ways, maybe make it feel slightly more chaotic than it actually is even. But at the heart of it, it still feels like the same game. It still works as the same game. And I think that's a great thing for them to do. So of course, that kind of answers the question, can Toucan play Kemet? And Toucan play Kemet. I really enjoy playing Kemet as a two-player game because you have that smaller board. You're still forced with the same amount of interaction as you would with more players. It is fantastic. It is one of my favourite games. It's one of those few games where I want to say, just go out and buy it. But unfortunately, there will be those people who don't like this game. And I can't answer whether or not that is you. So of course, my rule of thumb, as always, is for you to try before you buy. but I'd be surprised if you don't like Kemet, because it is absolutely brilliant. So, I hope you have found this review useful, and I hope you have enjoyed the rest of the videos in this series, and that you will view the rest of the videos on the channel, and of course, subscribe to the channel, share the channel, spread the channel far and wide across the internet, and as always, thanks for watching, and bye for now.